Good morning. Ooh, I don't know. That might be too hard to see. Can you see that very well, or is there too much light? I unmuted. Okay. Is it okay?
It's okay, but there's big sunshine. We'll see. It's dark. You're in the shade. Oh, yeah. Looks like you have a swimming pool.
Is that better? Or not necessarily?
Yes, that is better. Much better.
Okay, well, we'll go for it today. I thought this was a great idea. Maybe not so much so. So today we're doing, I'm going to go in the shade where I can maybe see you, yin yoga, which is, if you've taken class with me before, yeah, I'll love it. So it's where we hold a pose for 3 to 5 minutes, long, 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 nothing, not a hard pose, like we're not in warrior two, super deep or anything. It's like a pigeon, runner's lunge, stuff like that. Okay. And this is, look at today, I brought a candle out here, so hopefully you can smell. It's this beautiful lemon. So hopefully you can smell it. Maybe. We're going to start in child's pose. I can move over into the shade. So big toes together, knees wide, and you're just breathing here. I've even got notes to make. Long through your spine. So if your forehead doesn't quite reach the mat, set your head on your block. Allow your body to just relax here. Nice, slow, deep breaths in through your nose, out through your mouth. So remember, you can set that head on that block just to take that pressure, that tension off of your neck. Reaching those fingers long and just slowing that breath down. gently rock your head side to side. So you're just rolling that forehead on that mat. And then come to center, slowly come up onto your hands and knees for a tabletop position. Spread your fingers out wide. Press that padding between your pointer finger and thumb into the floor. Little cat-cow, inhale, lift your head and tailbone up, open across by chest. And then exhale, round out, point those toes, lift that spine up. Beautiful, inhale, curl the toes under, lift your chin up. Open across that chest. Exhale, round out, push that floor away. And one more time, inhale, curl the toes under, lift that chin. You're opening the front of that neck, opening that throat here, open that chest. Exhale, round out, push that floor away. And then come back to that neutral position. From here, curl your toes under, real easy, gentle down dog. Tailbone lifts way up high. Tuck your chin and look back between your legs, and then just gently pedal your feet out, bending one knee and then the other. Gently press both heels towards the floor, lengthening that spine. Inhale, lift your right leg up behind. Now look between your hands and swing that right leg through. Take your hand, put it on the inside of that right foot, walk that right foot out. So we're in a runner's lunge. You want to square your shoulders and hips to the front. Pull your heart forward, push your heel back, and breathe. Nice, slow, deep breaths here. Now maybe you can bend that back knee down onto the mat. You don't want to be on top of that kneecap with that hip closed. Really drive your hip forward. Walk your right foot a little bit farther forward. Maybe you can walk that left foot back. So you could stay here. Maybe you can come down on your forearms. Maybe, look, you could use that block and be here. Remember, we're hanging here for quite a while, so you want to get comfortable. Pull your heart forward. Push that heel back. Breathe. Let that head hang. Relax. Just breathe. If you can, maybe you can rest that head. So if you need to, rest it on a block. It also rested on your own hands, but you want to take that tension out of your neck so that you can surrender into the stretch.
slow that breath down. Let your body sink a little deeper into that stretch. We want to shift from doing to just being in the stretch and relaxing. Gently, slowly come up on those hands. Slide that block away. Lift that back knee, your left knee off the floor. Or actually, no, you don't need to. Take that right foot, sorry, walk it across. We're coming to pigeon. So your right toes are pointed and they come to your left hip. Your left leg extends back behind. You want to point those toes. And you know, we're just going to sink into the stretch. Breathe. Rotate that left hip around to the front. And again, using that block if you need to, forearms on it, you could rest your head on it. What we want to do is slow down, just sink into the stretch, just enjoy it, just breathe. Letting everything else just fade away and deepen the stretch. What if you're absolutely miserable here? Lay down on your back and do that figure four stretch, okay? Keep breathing here. Slowly walking your hands in and bringing your body up. Sitting on that right sits bone, and you're going to swing that left leg around to the front. So that left leg is straight. Flex your foot, left knee cup and toes are up. Take your right leg, cross it over for half cow. So we're trying to stack your right kneecap on, or right knee on top of that left kneecap, and that might not be happening. What you don't want to be doing is lifting that sits bones off the floor. So drive both sits bones down. pull this right foot back closer to your hip. Flex your left foot. Again, blocks are great. Box books, plenty of boxes. Just lean forward, stretch, breathe. Slow that breath in. No worries, no worries. Just relax here and breathe. Pulling your right hip back and try to fold a little farther forward, press that chest out. Nice, slow, deep breaths. This next one, take your blocks behind you in case you need them. So you're going to take that right leg, uncross. Now, slide over to the left side of your mat so that your right foot's going to stay on the mat here. This one's a little bit, we'll call it interesting. So you take your right foot back behind you. And then you're trying to get those knees together. And then we're going to slowly start to lean back. Try not to let that right hip pop up. Just breathe here. Slow that breath down. Maybe this is as much as you can do, and that's fine. Maybe you can go a little bit deeper. Maybe you want your forearms on those blocks.
Thank you.
Maybe you can lay all the way down. Slowly come up. Take that right leg, extend it out in front. Get that blood flowing back to that leg. Flex that foot. Just sit up tall here. And maybe hinging forward just a little bit. Make sure you don't forget where we're headed. Nice and easy, breathe. All right, fire log. So fire log is not like sitting cross-legged or Indian style where your feet are in close and your knees are out in front. Fire log is you're stacking your ankle on the opposite knee, okay? So blocks are very helpful here. Also helps to line yourself up, your shin up with the front of that mat. So flex your left foot and that left knee's dropping down. Take your right foot. Set that right ankle on your left knee and let that right knee drop. Now, what you don't want to be doing is holding it up and holding tension here. So you've got that block that you could set down. Maybe you need a block under this leg. Really what you want is to, like I said, not be holding your legs up, but let them just sink into the stretch. Both sit bones on the floor so your shoulders and hips are square to the front. Take an inhale through your nose, then we're going to start to lean forward. All right, breathing into it, sinking into it, doing what you can. Nice, slow, deep breaths. Make sure your feet are flexed. Almost done. Slow that breath down. Mm-hmm. slowly walk your hands in and bring yourself back. All right, take your legs around. We're gonna come to a tabletop position. Spread your fingers out wide. Now, usually your knees are under your hips. Take your knees back about 3 inches, all right? And we're just gonna circle around here, nice and slow. Change that circle direction. Beautiful, nice and easy. Come to that down dog. Curl those toes under, lift that tailbone up. Push your body back, lengthen your spine. Inhale, lift your left leg up behind. Look between your hands and swing that left leg through. Take that left hand, bring it on the inside of your left foot. Walk your left foot out to the side, out to the left. Square your hips and shoulders to the front. Pull your heart forward, breathe. So you could stay here. What you don't want is your back rounded out with that hip up high. So if you needed to, hands on that locker, drive your right hip forward and down. Breathe. Bend that right knee to the floor, walk that back, walk your left foot a little farther forward. You could stay here, maybe you can come down those forearms, maybe you need those forearms on the block. Relax into that stretch. Slow that breath down. Slowly come up on your hands, moving in a pigeon, so that left foot comes across. Pointing those toes so that left foot's at your right hip. Rotate that right hip around the front. Walk that right foot back. Point your toes from the top of that foot. And slowly fold forward. Beautiful. Breathe. So remember, if you need to use that lock, if you're miserable here in pigeon, roll on your back, figure four stretch, okay? Slow that breath in. Slowly bring your body up, walking those hands in. Slide that block off to the side, spin that left hip, and swing that right leg around. So your right leg is straight, and then half cow, keep that left leg crossed up and in. So try to stack that left knee on top of that right knee back. Pull that left hip back. I like sitting a block on either side of that straight leg. Both sits bones on the floor. Inhale here. And lean those forearms on those blocks. Keep pulling your heart forward. Slow that breath down. Allow yourself to relax a little deeper into this stretch. Slowly bring your body up. All right, so this is that funky one. Take that left leg uncrossed. So I like to slide over on that mat because it bugs the inside of my big toe to be on that hard floor. So I slide over and then bend that left leg in. Try to get that left sit bone on the floor. And then maybe you can just lean back here. Lift that chest up. Slow that breath down. So try not to hold your breath. Try not to hold that tension. Really try to relax. Maybe you can bend those arms a little bit, get a little deeper. Listen to your body. Maybe you can come down on those forearms. Thank you. Maybe for an hour. Then slowly bring yourself back up. Take that left leg, extend it out in front. Flex that foot. Nice and gentle here. Maybe a little slide forward and up. Get that blood moving back in that leg. Good. Keep going. One more time here. All right, fire log. So, line that right shin up with the front of that mat so that your foot's not in too close. Let that knee drop open. Remember, if you need to, you've got that block. Left foot on top of that right knee. Let those knees gently drop open. So, if you need to, start with that block. Sit up tall, breathe. Both sits bones on the floor so your body's not all twisted. And then maybe you can start to lean forward. See how we're doing on time. Slowly walking your hands in. Uncross those legs. Come to that tabletop position once again. So fingers spread wide, shoulders over your wrists. Take your knees about 3 inches behind your hips. Really as a circle around. Circle that other direction. All right, so we're going to sit in a straddle stretch facing the side wall. Now, what your body wants to do is to have your hips and your legs roll forward. So really think about rolling those legs open. Try to get your kneecaps facing the ceiling. Inhale, sit up nice and tall. And then maybe you can start to walk those hands forward. Use that block if you need to. Press that chest out maybe. So what you don't want is your back rounded out. So if that's happening, bring your hands in, sit up a little taller, leave your hands on that block. Then press your chest out. Nice and easy here. Deepening that stretch. Bring your body up, step nice and tall. And then bring that leg around to the front. Flex your feet, sit up tall. Here, take an inhale. Reach your arms long. Exhale, push forward, pressing that chest out. Maybe you can grab your feet. Long, long through your spine. If you're super flexible, maybe block under your feet. Pulling that heart forward and just melt into the stretch.
Thank you.
Loading, roll yourself up, sit up nice and tall. Bending your knees, your feet are flat on the floor. And then we're slowly lift all the way down. Pulling your knees tight into your chest. And then gently rocking side to side on your back. And come to center, keep that right knee in and extend that left leg down below. Just gonna flex that left foot, push that heel through that front. Keep that right knee in tight. Take an inhale here, take that right knee across your body, so you get this gentle twist, right arm up to the side. Slowly come back to center, pull that right knee tight. Then place that right on the floor, pull that left knee tight into your chest. Extend that right leg down below, flex that foot, right kneecap and toes face the ceiling. Left arm out to the side. Gentle twist. Slowly come back to center, pull that left knee tight into your chest. Bring both knees tight into your chest, take an inhale, bring your knees to your forehead. And then release down in the final Shavasana. Be wide on your mat, let your feet pop open, arms down by your side. Your palms are up and just breathe.
allowing your eyes to sink into your eye sockets. Allowing your face to relax. Give your fingers and toes a little wiggle here. Add those ankles and wrists. Take an inhale, extend your arms long over top, legs up a little. And then let that air out. Bending your knees, your feet are flat on the floor, roll into a side, use that arm as a pillow, we'll take a few breaths here. Gently and effortlessly help yourself come all the way up, facing front in Sukhasana. Rotate your shoulders back and around, crown of your head reaches for the ceiling. Bring your hands together, heart center. Take an inhale through your nose. Open mouth, exhale. Remember that a stumbling block could be an opportunity. Take an inhale through your nose. Exhale. Bring your thumbs to your third eye. One more inhale. And exhale. Bowing forward. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you like the yin yoga today. See you next week.